Mr. Speaker, Tiruchi Shiva.
Thank you, Mr. Vice Chairman, sir. Sir, I stand here on behalf of the DMK party, stand with my held high, belonging to a party which was the pioneer of social justice, a self-respect party, to support this bill, the 127th amendment to the Constitution. Sir, why I stand my held high? It was in the year 1927 itself that our parent party, Justice Party, was ruling the Madras Presidency. The first communal GO was introduced, providing reservations to all the people, all the sections of the people. And in 1951, the first amendment to the Constitution was made. Thanks to the struggle and agitation that happened in Tamil Nadu, spearheaded by Thandai Periyar, Arinyar Anna, Dr. Kalaignar and Kamarajar, and it was Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru who made the first amendment to the Constitution providing reservations. And this government has brought in this amendment only out of compulsion. What you have done, you are undoing now. The Supreme Court on 5th May 2021 in the Maratha case held very clearly that the President, on the recommendations of the National Commission for Backward Classes, would designate the communities to be included in the OBC list. It also observed that the state power to make reservation in favour of particular communities or castes or quantum of reservations, the nature of benefits and the kind of reservation and all other matters falling within the ambit of Articles 15 and 16 remains undisturbed except with respect to identification of SEBCs. As a result of which, 671 OBC communities belonging their reservations in educational and employment institutions were affected. So it's a compulsion. And I should mention here, at least my colleagues in the opposition party would have noted that and would have been happier. In all these years of this government's rule, this is the first ever time they have mentioned with a view to maintain the federal structure of this country. All these days, all their bills that were enacted as last year and their activities were unfederal. This is the first ever time. It's with a view to in the consideration of the federal nature of this country. That too under the pressure of, rather, the situation has warranted that it has to be done, that this bill provides, empowers the states and union territories to select their own and notify the OBC list in their respective states and the union territories. And second, sir, when the Minister for Social Justice in his introductory speech very proudly said that 4,000 medical college seats have been given to the OBCs because of their intervention. Sir, I should say again, only because our party president and Tamil Nadu Chief Minister Mr. M.K. Stalin sought the High Court of Madras with a writ petition, the 27% reservation should be allotted in the medical colleges which the states have shared with the central pool. The government was compelled because it led up to a contempt. Sir, these things have to be considered because we stand here, you do everything out of compulsion, not with the intention of upholding the rights of the states or union territories. Because federalism is not a suitable word to you. You always concentrate on one language, one nation, one religion, everything one. But we are not for that. It is a composite culture nation with multilingual, multi-regional and everything which has to be upheld. And that is the fundamental feature of our, unique feature of our constitution. Here I have to say, sir, again, very importantly, in the same judgment, the court has said that, it said that the 50% ceiling could be breached in case of exceptional circumstances. But in this case, it said that the exceeding of ceiling limit without there being any exceptional circumstance clearly violates Article 14 and 16. So, sir, whether to decide which is the exceptional circumstances lies with the court. any law that is legislated must be unambiguous. So it is very imperative that we have to address this ambiguity in such things. What is this exceptional circumstances? So you have to concentrate on all those things. If a state or even the center legislate or include something, the court may not accept that it is an exceptional circumstance. So we insist two things very much. Kindly look into the lifting of the 50% cap in providing reservations. That is very, very important. So also in Tamil Nadu, there are 80%, 90% of the backward classes community. The reservation is only 50%. So the states have to be provide duly the share of the respective OBC communities in their states. The caste-wise census has to be conducted, which the union government has to take into consideration. This is very important, sir. Unless and otherwise, the allotment, the allocation of the reservation percentage to the respective communities in the states will not be proportionate. So the state-wise, the census should be immediately conducted. We have to concentrate on lifting the 50% cap, which prevents, sir, but for the reservation, the socially and educationally suppressed classes would not have come up. We have come across centuries of suppression. Thanks to the great fighting of against, to say, Periyar, Anna, Kalaingar, Jojarao Pule, Narayana Guru, Kamarajar, and so many leaders, and on this path, our present leader, Mr. M.K. Stalin, is leading, and we will fight for always the social justice causes, and we support this bill only on this ground. And kindly, hereafter, whenever you attempt to do something, do that in the interest of the people, not out of the compulsion of the court. Thank you very much.